The untouchables are not allowed to enter temples, not allowed to come near sources of drinking water used by other castes, not allowed to eat sitting next to a caste Hindu or to use the same utensils.
As for like really knowing that we're untouchables, I think it was like around 7 years old. People weren't touching us. Somebody asked me for matches and I was giving them, and they put their hand like this and asked me to drop it. As soon as I came to America, obviously I didn't know anybody but some Indians, and I had to be with them. I didn't feel very welcome with them. As time went on, they treated me very badly. After that, I never befriended any Indians. I'm not plugged into any Indian networks. By necessity, I would be interacting with upper caste Brahmins. And I knew for sure that my life would have been much worse in terms of caste discrimination, socially, if not career-wise and stuff. You know.
Manjula, my mother, and Durga Kumari, her friend, faced an unspoken problem at the entrance to a temple. As an untouchable, Manjula was not supposed to enter. Should Durga Kumari pretend to be oblivious of her friend's uncleanness and walk in beside her? What should Manjula do?
It's a general idea that Gandhi was a champion of untouchables. That is like a really false idea. He was not only anti-untouchable and anti-Muslim, but he's also anti-black racist. Taxi! So you tell us that we're not touchable and we should be loyal to this country? How is that?
I came from a very small town, and women are supposed to be very shy and demure and keep to themselves. I didn't like that at all. I was always attracted to things that only boys are supposed to be doing. I saw females driving the train and I was very impressed. I was in total awe of them. In 2009, because of the Wall Street crash, I lost my job. So I remembered that, oh, I took the test for conductor, so let me go and check if I'm still on the list. So they were about to take my name off the list. The thing that I wanted most from America is that to be carefree and not to be so limited as Indian women are. I'm one of those people that don't believe that books can make any kind of change. I think that the best I can hope from this is that other people outside of India will come to know that there is such a horrible and inhuman institution such as caste exists in India.